Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Good morning, welcome to our service for Stephen. There are, of course, a lot more people who would love to be here or would want to be here on this day, but of course, either the Atlantic Ocean or the rules that we're living under today mean that they can't be here. So as we begin, those of us who are able to be here, we remember all Stephen's family and his friends in the States who will be thinking of him and who are missing this occasion. And also many, certainly friends from the Minster who would want to be here as well. Perhaps others, family and friends who are unable to be here as well. So we hold them all who are grieving for Stephen, in our hearts and in our minds as we share in this short service together. So let's just be still for a moment and call to mind our memories of Stephen, and then I will say an opening prayer. Let's just be still for a moment or two. Gather today to pray for Stephen as he comes closer to you now in death. We come to give thanks for his life, for his love, for the memories we will hold dear of him. And we come to surround him with our love and with our prayers as he comes closer to you now. And we come also to pray for Elizabeth and all his family and friends in this country and in the States who love him and miss him. We pray that you will be their comfort and their strength and their companion in these days and weeks and months of grief. So we offer this service, we offer these prayers, and above all, we offer Stephen into your presence today, in the name of our risen Lord, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
God of all consolation, your Son, Jesus Christ, was moved to tears at the grave of Lazarus, his friend. Look with compassion on us, your children, in our loss. Give to troubled hearts the light of hope, and strengthening us the gift of faith in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now I'm going to read a tribute that was written by Jody, and then Heather is going to say a few words from Stephen's children, I think, back in the States. Stephen was born on the 2nd of February 1952 in Richmond, Indiana, to George and Mavis. He has two sisters, Vicky and Sandra. When Stephen was 10 years old, his father died in a terrible accident. It broke Stephen's heart. He never really got over the loss of his father. Stephen enlisted in the US Army and he went to Vietnam at 18. This was a very hard part of his life, and he suffered many flashbacks through the years. On return from war, he went on to have four children, one son Jonathan, and three daughters, Renia, Heather, and Presley. Although he lived very far apart from his children, he adored them all and always spoke fondly of them. All but one have visited him here. Presley, the youngest, had planned to come to see him in the near future. Stephen married Elizabeth in 1994. He loved living in England, especially York and Buttercrown, where they lived most recently. He made many new friends in York and really enjoyed his job at the Minster. He always maintained a very close bond with lifelong friends Leondis and Jim, even though they lived in America. He was also extremely close with his cousin Mark, who lives in California. Stephen's biggest passion was his music. He was an amazing singer-songwriter and even won top honours in the folk division of the National Music Festival for Disabled Veterans in 1985 for his song Names Upon the Wall. Stephen was always at his happiest while playing, singing and performing at different venues or at home. I will remember him most for his live music. I'll invite Heather to read some messages from his children. Do you want to come up here? Or you can do it where you like.
Yeah, I'll do it here.
Okay.
Thank you. And this one is from Sandy. This is one of his younger sister. Brother, I miss you with my whole heart and soul. I will forever long to hear a new song or for you to make me laugh when I'm sad. I will never look at nature without thinking of you and how much you loved it. I don't know what my life is supposed to look like without you. I seem to be walking aimlessly in circles with an emptiness that can't be filled. I know when it's my time you will be there to greet me. We talked about that. Nothing like here. Thank you. And this one is from Sandy. This is one of his younger sister. Brother, I miss you with my whole heart and soul. I will forever long to hear a new song or for you to make me laugh when I'm sad. I will never look at nature without thinking of you and how much you loved it. I don't know what my life is supposed to look like without you. I seem to be walking aimlessly in circles with an emptiness that can't be filled. I know when it's my time you will be there to greet me. We talked about that. Nothing will keep you from it. I love you. Always have, always will. And I will never forget your words to me when you said, don't you ever think that I don't love you. Those words will get me through. God bless you till we meet again. From his sister Vicky, I miss you and love you. I remember the good old days when we weren't old or good. Lots of fond memories. Love and miss you forever. A few more.
It's okay.
From his cousin Mark, from his fantastic sense of humour to his incredible singing voice to his amazingly sensitive lyrics, Stephen was a true original. We bonded together as children in our small Midwestern Indiana city and carried that bond into adulthood. Even though we were now separated by an ocean, time and distance didn't matter, as we are always inseparable in spirit. My dear cousin, my dear friend, you'll be missed mightily. The world is a lesser place without you in it. Much love, Mark. From his daughter, Renee. Dad, your life was a blessing, your memory a treasure. You are loved beyond words and missed beyond measure. From his daughter, Precia. You let me go that summer day. I thought that you had walked away from a little girl in the doorway who couldn't let you go, who missed you more as time marched on, clung to the lyrics of a song, felt lost when she knew you were gone and wondered if you'd know. You traveled through those painful ways, felt the regret of yesterdays, yet somehow the light inside you stays, a beacon of everlasting hope. You were the place in my heart called home. And anywhere that I would roam, I found you there. I found my own song within your notes. You've let me go the summer day. I thought that you had walked away until I realized you have stayed within my heart and soul. Now I carry you as you carried me, and everything that I may see speaks to your life and legacy. Daddy, I let you go. From his best friend, Leondis. Steve, my lifelong friend, I miss that little blue light blinking at 2 a.m. on my phone and dot on my WhatsApp mornings now. You don't realize how comforting that was. You've overcome so much the last few years. We always knew that one day one of us was going to feel pain and loss. I'm glad it's me that has to deal with it. Even though I feel it should have been me first. Just one thing, buddy, save me a place in line. We still got an eternity to share together. love you till we meet again. You brought a lifetime of wonderful memories and laughter into my life. Thanks, friend. From my mum, you are the love of my life, and I miss you so much. This is from me. You came into my life when I was 19. We have so many fun times and memories. One of my best ones is when you and Mum came to London to see me and cheer me up after my breakup from Storm's dad. You took me to a West End show playing. You told me to stay strong, that better days are coming. I will miss you forever, and my heart is so small. Now you are gone. I hope you meet up with your dad and you found Wayne up there too. Just one last thing. He's not just a canine, he's not just a hound. Frank the Beagle, the most handsome dog around. Thank you.
Thank you, Helen. That was hard, but lovely. So with those memories, that those words evoke, and with the people who sent the messages in our hearts and minds, a prayer, the collect for a funeral service. Merciful Father, hear our prayers and comfort us. Renew our trust in your Son, whom you raised from the dead. Strengthen our faith that all who have died in the love of Christ will share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Bible reading is from John chapter 14. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. The power and the glory forever and ever. Amen." Would you please stand for the commendation and committal? So let us commend Stephen to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. God, our Creator and Redeemer, by your power, Christ conquered death and entered into glory. Confident of his victory and claiming his promises, we entrust Stephen to your mercy. In the name of Jesus, our Lord, who died and is alive and reigns with you, now and forever. Amen. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy, slow to anger and of great goodness. As the Father is tender towards his children, so is the Lord tender to those that fear him. For he knows of what we are made. He remembers that we are but dust. Our days are like the grass. We flourish like a flower of the field. When the wind goes over it, it is gone, and its place will know it no more. But the merciful goodness of the Lord endures for ever and ever toward those that fear him, and his righteousness upon their children's children. So we have entrusted our beloved Stephen to God's mercy. We now commit his body to be cremated, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, in sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform our frail bodies, that they may be conformed to his glorious body, who died, was buried, and rose again for us. To him be glory forever. Amen. my head and in my understanding. God be in my eyes and in my looking. God be in my mouth and in my speaking. God be in my heart and in my thinking. God be at my end and at my departing. May God give you his comfort and his peace, his light and his joy in this world and the next. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with each and every one of you, all those you love, all those you pray for, today and always. Amen. Please sit down for a few moments as another piece of Stephen's music plays as we conclude together.